Having a bad day? Seems like you just can't get it up this morning? Dean, you're bored, and you don't want to wait for the surf shop to fix it? Here's how. Hi, I'm going to show you how to do three basic ding repairs. The rail ding, the buckle board, and the fin job. You can be a dweeb and have the surf shops fix it for you. Then you'll always be a dweeb and never score chicks like this. Here's a demonstration board. For the sake of speed, here's a rail ding. Now there's two ways to fix it. You could either use a file or you could use a grinder to grind it out. But since we have the grinder, who needs the file? First, we have to tape off the area around the ding. When you begin to sand, start at a slow RPM so you don't rip the glass and make the ding worse. Here's a little trick of the trade, styrene. Get yourself a brush, dab a little bit on there. I got holes in the can. Brush it on, and it takes all the fractures away. After the styrene, cut up a half dozen patches, 4 to 6 ounce cloth, and set them next to the ding. Next is laminating resin. This should be enough. Next is the catalyst. You want to use 3 to 5 cc's at 70 degrees. First, you want to put a little bit of resin on the ding. Then you want to start with your patchwork. One patch, then resin. One patch, then resin. You want to work the resin into the glass. You want to work out all the air bubbles and work up the layers. That way it gives you something to sand. You want to put one big patch over everything to kind of cap it. Just work it in. After the resin has hardened in about 20 to 30 minutes, you can apply the sanding coat. When mixing your sanding coat, you want to add surfacing agent and a little bit more catalyst than usual. I'm applying, you just need a little bit on there. Give the hot coat about an hour to dry, then you're ready to sand.
Time to go surfing.
The hot coat's been drying for about an hour. Now we're ready to sand.
First, we have to plug in.
Now that we finished machining with 80 grit, we're going to hand sand with 80. Run your fingers over and you can feel if there's a lump or not. If you need to hand sand more, that feels pretty good. Now we're going into that 120, finishing it up. Now we're ready for the wipe down finish. This is the final stage. It's a floor finish. Any kind of floor finish will work. And just apply a little bit on a rag and wipe down. Just a couple wipes and you're done with the rail ding. That wipeout there could easily result in a buckled board like this. One of the main reasons a board buckles is because of a rail ding that wasn't fixed. First, you want to tape off the area that you're going to sand. When you're setting up your grinder, use a new piece of sandpaper, and when you start to sand, use light pressure so you don't overheat your board. At this point, we haven't broken through the glass, we just roughed up the area. The next step is to route out the fracture. For routing, you want to set the bit 1/8 inch deep. Now that I just routed it all out, now we get to fill it back in. Excuse me. The next step is to use resin and Q-cell. This is Q-cell. It is not, and I repeat, not to be mistaken for any similar looking substance.
Over the ledge. Pitfall.
Yeah. Q-cell is like a foam filler. You add it to the resin and stir till it forms a thick paste. We have about 2 ounces of resin and we're going to add in about 2.5 to 3 cc's of catalyst. Mix it in good. Okay, at this stage, you want to work clean. You don't want to get the stuff all over. The bigger the mess you make, the longer it's going to take to clean up. Just work it down. Make sure you get it all filled in. Come back with a piece of tape. Don't have it quite filled in yet, folks. And wrap it back over. That way it gets your rail line. and finish it up. After the resin has dried, you want to sand down the Q-cell. Remember, do not overheat the glass. If you want to get fancy, you can match the colors, but if you're colorblind like I am, you might want to have your photographer tell you what kind of color to get. Hey, Steve, how's this look?
Oh, couldn't be closer.
Now this color I can do. When you're cutting out your glass, you want the smaller piece on the bottom and the bigger piece on top. Then you want to round your edges so when you go to sand, it's a lot easier to ferret in. You're going to need a fair amount of resin for this job. We have about 4 ounces of resin, and we're adding in about 5 cc's of catalyst. Mixed it in good. When applying the resin, you just want to pour a small amount on, and with a real light touch, so you don't move the cloth that went around. Just work it all over. Add a little bit more if necessary. Remember, you want to work clean. You don't want to leave a bunch of globs of resin. The whole key to working with fiberglass is to work clean. Get everything really wet and saturated for your lap. Now you're ready, and it's real easy. Want to make sure you get all the excess resin off and get yourself a nice clean wrap. It's been about an hour. It's dry, and now we're ready for the hot coat. Surf skin agent is just styrene and wax in there to make it for when you're sanding your repair, that it doesn't gum up the sandpaper. You just want to make it a little bit hotter than what you did with the lamination. Time to apply the hot coat resin. Just pour a little bit on and just work it over the ding. If you have any extra little fibers like this, you can work it in with your finger real quick. and they disappear. Make sure you cover the whole board and get the rail. That board should be dry by now. This feels dry enough. You want to rip off your tape so you don't gum up your sandpaper. And we're starting off with a hard pad and 80 grit. Now we're going to go over it real quick with a block. When you're sanding the rail, don't overdo it. This is where most people oversand. Next, we're going to fine-tune the edge. Follow the rail line. Just need to make a couple passes. Next, we're going to hand sand the bottom with 120 to do the finished sanding. Now we're ready for the wipe down finish. That didn't come out too bad. Nice color match, Steve. Next, we're ready for the pin job. There's two ways to take off a fin, the easy way or the manly way. For you guys who are not feeling manly, we'll do it the grinder way. Now we're gonna grind off the fin. First we're gonna start off grinding off the base. Then we're gonna flip it up on the rail and come in from this angle. We wanna get all the rope out so when we go to knock off the fin, it comes out clean. I just finished grinding the fin rope, but not the bottom lamination. That's all there is to it. Notice everything is ground down flush. Now we can go into the next step. Now that we got the fins off, it's time to apply resin and Q-cell. You want to work in the Q-cell into all the cracks. Then build it up with your squeegee. For the Q-cell, now we let it dry, then we sand it. We'll give it about 20 minutes. It should be ready by now. It feels dry, not tacky. It's ready to sand. We got everything smoothed out now. Now we're ready to put the patches over. Okay, you want to cut out your patches and put it over the Q-cell. The reason why is because if you don't, the fin will bust out, you have nothing holding down the Q-cell. And you want to curve your patches so when you sand, it fares in a lot easier. I'm just mixing a batch of laminating resin for this. Just want a little bit on there. Apply light pressure at first. On this side, I gotta wrap the rail a little bit. Remember, don't leave any globs of resin. It's a lot easier to take it off now when it's wet than when it's hard. You gotta sand it off. That's it. Before you get ready to stick your fins on, you want to cut out your fin rope and cut out your patches. The way you're going to do that is take the fin, put it down on the fiberglass. I got two layers for each side of the fin of 6 ounce fiberglass. Throw your fin down and you want to cut around it so you got plenty of room to work with when you're laying up your fin. Round off your edges. That way it makes it easier for sanding. Okay, then take your fin rope and your fin and measure it out. We got two fin jobs here to do, so we'll go one, two, four. Now we're ready to tack on the fins. Two ways to set up your fins. One way you can set it up with tape. And a square to get your angle, or a hot glue gun, which is the faster way. We're going to be using a hot glue gun. Make sure the bottom of your fin is nice and clean. Put a nice little bead on there. Line it up with your marks. And hold it for a couple seconds. Then after the glue dries, you want to go back and trim it with a razor blade. Want it about a quarter inch off 90. Then after you get that set up, you want to go back and mix resin and run a bead along the side of the fin. But since we're on a time schedule, we're going to go back and hot glue it. Next is you want to get your fin patches in place. Two patches per side. Get your fin rope ready, then it's going to be mixing resin. You don't need a whole bunch of resin. Okay, first of all, get your fin rope. Get a little resin on your fingers. Wet out the cloth, the rope, and then you start dipping it in, working the resin into the rope. Then pull tight on the rope to get the excess resin off. next step, get your scissors. You want sharp scissors for this. Lay down the rope alongside the fin. You want to leave about a half inch on each side of the fin. Once you got your rope down, you want to get yourself a brush. Dab a little bit of resin on there. Just real lightly hit it up on the fin, both sides. Now, you want to come back, get a little dab of resin on your fiberglass patch. If your rope is sagged down, push it back up with the brush. And put the patch on. Just putting it on real lightly. Now you got your patches on, come back and wet out the cloth. Just using really light pressure to put the resin on. Notice I'm working around the board and not over it. That way I don't get resin all over the board. Okay, the next step, you want to get the air bubbles out of the rope. So you take your two fingers, middle fingers, and just work it back and forth on both sides. Once you got that done, come back with your squeegee. If you can, have a rounded edge on that. That way when you go to get the resin out of the cloth, you get it, the rope form too. Then once you get to that stage, you go back with your thumb and get the form. You want to form the cloth and the fin rope. You want to make sure to get, you don't want to feel any lumps right in here. Feel some lumps, that means it's fin rope, and you want to get it down. And you don't want to feel any lumps in here, because that's fin rope there. You want to get it up, you want it all the rope right in this area. That's the main mistake people make. And that's basically it.
Can we breathe yet?
Notice I don't have a big mess all over. Every time you work with resin, you want to make sure you do a clean job. You don't want to leave chunks of resin all over. It's a lot easier to get it now when it's wet than when it's hard. After about 15, 20 minutes, your fin should be hard enough to cut out with a razor blade. want to give yourself some room here for when you come back to sand, you got something to foil. After we get the fins trimmed out, we're going to apply the hot coat resin, the sanding coat. Again, you don't want to glob anything on, you just want to put on a nice, even coat. Next, we sand. It's the new suit rod on the count to pick up those nice girls.
Like Devo, huh?
Since this board's been sitting here for about a month, I think we're ready to sand. First, we're gonna start with the grinder. Knock off the front and back edge. Then we're going to come in with a hard pad. I like using a smaller hard pad so you can get in between the fins. Now we're going to pull off the tape. Now that we're done with the grinder, we're ready for the hard pad. I did not get into any of the fiberglass around the fin rope area. Next, we're going to foil the fins. Notice I did not sand into the fiberglass, and I already have part of my foil sanded in. Now we're going to start the hand sand. Now that we're done rough sanding, we're ready for the 120. Now we're ready for the wipe down finish. Thank you. That's all there is to it.
Harbor, Caesar at 5 feet, with a period of 11 seconds. Wayfarer buoy at Marina Monterey Bay, Caesar at 12 feet, 15 seconds. Coastal observations, Bodega Marine Lab, east at 15. Point Bonita, east northeast at 7, gust to 14. Pillar Point is calm, partly cloudy with haze. Pigeon Point is calm. Point Pinos, wind north at 7, air pressure 30.21 and partly cloudy. This 4 a.m. report will be updated around 7:30 a.m.
Yeah. Oh,
a large 47 millibar low lies tonight. Wind becoming southeast to 15 knots. Tuesday, wind south to 21. Tonight, swell west 16 feet. Wind south 20 to 30 knots. Wind waves 4 to 6 feet. Highest winds and waves in the north and a chance of showers in the north. Tuesday, swell northwest 14 to 18 feet.
Throwing in a little bonus for you guys, the fin box repair. The only way you can do this repair is with a router. You want to make your cut right down the channel and take it all the way down to the foam. Just checking the box right now to see if it's ready to pop out. Looks like it could use a little bit more routing. You want to get all the resin and fiberglass out after you get the box out. Next step is to route out the delaminated fiberglass. Next, we're ready to sink the fin box. I'm gonna get everything taped off before you use the resin so you don't make a big mess. And when you use the tape, you wanna use a good quality 3M tape. You wanna get everything taped off around your fin. Next, you wanna make a mark on your stringer right down the center so you know where your fin box lines up. Then you make one on your fin box. That way you know where center is. We're adding Q-cell to the resin and catalyst to help fill the cavity around the box. You want to get a fair amount in here to cover up the sides. Now we're ready to stick in the fin box. Just work it around, sink it all the way down. Get your lines lined up. Once you got the box in, now you could add in the extra Q-cell. After you got everything filled in, now you could come back with your squeegee and clean everything up. Now it's time to adjust the fin. Everything's dry now, so we're ready to grind down the fin box. Notice I sanded around the fin box so your fiberglass has something to bond to. Now we're going to put on some liquid carbon fiber strips. This really isn't liquid carbon, it's just a fill pin. Now that we're done with the touch-up, we're ready for resin and fiberglass. Remember to round your edges on your patches and apply tape. Now that we got the resin and catalyst mixed, it's time to apply the patches. The small patch first, then the bigger patch. Then apply the resin. You want to keep away from the box at first. Just working in. Using a light touch at first just to get it, the resin moved around. Then kind of real lightly go over the box with just a small amount of resin. Work the resin in, then work out the excess. For any air bubbles or globs of resin, then we just wait for it to dry. The laminating resin is hard. Now we're ready to do the hot coat. Just brush it on. That's it. We wait for it to get tacky, then we cut out the middle. The hot coat is tacky now, so we're ready to cut. After you got your box trimmed, you can come back and pull your tape. If you got any resin and that overlaps your tape, come back and clean up the razor blade. First, we're going to start off with a hard pad and 80 grit. Remember, just use light pressure. Now we're ready just to file up around the edges of the box. And that's it for the fin box. Thank you.